Today I am going to present a case report of low dose naltrexone in a patient of Pele kidney disease. What is Pele kidney disease? Pele kidney disease is a rare and debilitating genodermatosis which is characterized by fissuring chronic vesicles, fissuring and maceration in the bowel areas. There is a mutation in ATP A2C1G coding a calcium can be transported in Golgi apparatus, which leads to disturbed calcium hemostasis and formation of fistulas. It is aggravated by heat and shear stress, and it leads to poor quality of life in the patient. So I am going to present the case of 45-year-old female who was a known case of diabetes and hypertension since last 10 years, and she was resident of Marsella. She had multiple raised lesions on the neck, axilla, submammary area, groin, trunk, and behind both knees since last 8 years. The lesions were associated with burning and itching, and if they were aggravated during the summer season. She went to multiple doctors and she had no response from her disease. These are her photographs. First slide is showing the groin area, which has intimate scars, different scars with sand crack appearance, axilla and groin. This is the popliteal region. We can see intimate crack, sand crack appearance. We performed skin biopsy for histopathology, which showed basket leaf hyperkeratosis, focal hyperkeratosis, and supra-basinal cleft, and depalitated brick wall appearance of basal keratinocytes. This is her histopathological picture, which is classical for the Pele kidney disease. So we started, we did some literature review and started her on naltrexone, tablet naltrexone, which is available as Nalorex 50 mg, and we started 1/4 tablet on alternate days because we didn't have the facility of compounding the low dose naltrexone. And we, along with this, treated superelevated infection with fusidic acid only. So this is the response of the patient after 3 months of therapy with low dose naltrexone. This is after the 6 months of the therapy. The patient has shown the clearance of her axilla lesion. This is the popliteal region after 6 months of therapy. This is submammary area after 6 months. And these pictures are Friday pictures, the day before tomorrow. The pictures, present pictures, after about 9 months. She is still clear of the disease. This is popliteal fossa. So till now we have only 3 articles available on the treatment of Pele kidney disease with low dose naltrexone. The first one published was in 2017 in JAMA, and the other and two case series are were reported in the JAMA JAD and in the British Journal of Dermatology. This is from JAMA Dermatology. What may be the likely mechanism of action of naltrexone in Pele kidney disease? Naltrexone is an opioid antagonist, and opioid receptors are known to be existing on the basal keratinocytes. It inhibits the opioid receptors, and it may modulate these receptors in the basal layer of epidermis, resulting in increased intracellular adhesion and wound healing. It is also a toll-like receptor 4 inhibitor, and it is an anti-inflammatory agent. It also increases the availability of calcium, which would allow for proper differentiation of keratinocyte and wound healing. Side effects may be mild, like headache, nausea, and vivid dreams. Other diseases which respond to low dose naltrexone are Crohn disease, multiple sclerosis, and rheumatoid arthritis, and some other autoimmune diseases and psychiatric diseases. So to conclude, the significant improvement of the symptoms in these patients, along with medication's low adverse effect profile, and a reasonable cause suggests low dose naltrexone is a level, as a normal treatment of hereditary disease. And but the large scale studies are should be done in the hospitals to see the exact efficacy. And we should also look for the efficacy of naltrexone in the other calcium dependent diseases like hereditary disease. Thank you.